If you work in the dry cleaning trade, you are part of an important industry in Canada. Most dry cleaners use tetrachloroethylene, also known as PERC. Many work with it every day, so it makes sense to learn about PERC and its environmental and health impacts and the federal dry cleaning regulations. You also may want to check if your province or territory has regulations to protect your workers from health concerns in the use of PERC. PERC is a very effective cleaning agent. It's clear and has a mildly sweet odor, and it can be dangerous. Don't be fooled. PERC is toxic to the environment. That's why Environment Canada has regulations to control PERC. These risks, however, can be managed by following the dry cleaning regulations and these steps. When cleaning with PERC, the detergents, dirt, and lint end up as wastewater and residue, which all contain PERC. The fumes from PERC can get into the air around you, and they are not good for your health or the environment. That means you must keep wastewater and residue containing PERC in a closed container. If your machine empties wastewater through a hose into a bucket, that bucket must have a lid on it. The lid can have a hole in it for the hose to pass through. The lint, residue, sludge, and material from the still also need to be stored in a closed container. All this waste contains PERC. Be careful with machine waste and wastewater. Keep the PERC-containing wastewater and residue containers closed. Waste coming out of the dry cleaning machine contains PERC. Sometimes spills happen. Sometimes machines will leak. That's why we protect around and under the machine so no PERC leaks onto the floor. Leaks could lead to contaminated soil and water, and proper environmental cleanup can be very expensive. Place the machine, closed wastewater buckets, and closed waste residue drum, anything that contains PERC, into another container or tray. This is called secondary containment. Your containment system must be PERC impermeable, which means that it must not allow PERC to go through. Also, this protective containment tray has to be able to hold 110% of the volume of the largest container in or on it. That means that if the machine leaks, the tray would be able to hold all the liquid that was in the machine, plus a bit more. One more thing, if liquid containing PERC does spill, it is critical to plug the floor drains immediately with PERC-resistant plugs. Those floor drains empty into the city drains, and the liquid containing PERC could harm the environment and even harm the water supply. You must have enough PERC-resistant plugs for all your drains and make sure these are handy. Protect the environment and your property by placing your machine and your storage containers in secondary containment. And remember the 110% rule. Also remember to have PERC-resistant plugs for your drains close by. You can't keep wastewater or residue with PERC in it lying around. You must treat all your wastewater on site or, at least once a year, transport all your wastewater and residue to a licensed waste management facility. There are three key things to remember. Don't let wastewater and residue with PERC in it hang around longer than allowed by the federal dry cleaning regulations. Be sure the transport and disposal is done by licensed professionals, and keep your transfer records and receipts for 5 years. Dispose of all your wastewater and residue properly at least once a year to protect yourself and the environment. PERC is an important chemical for many in the dry cleaning business. When using PERC, you are legally responsible to prevent PERC releases. That means your business may be inspected to be sure you comply with the regulations. Not complying with the PERC regulations is an offense under the Canadian Environmental Protection Act 1999, and you can be fined up to $4 million or more. By complying with the dry cleaning regulations, you will be helping to protect your health and the environment that you share with your family. Thanks for watching.